वेलकम व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। सो इन माय प्रीवियस क्लास और इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव स्टार्टेड द कंटिन्यूटी एंड डिफेंसिबिलिटी चैप्टर एंड दैट एंड इन दैट चैप्टर आई हैव प्रोवाइडेड सम सॉल्यूशन फ्रॉम आई फर्स्ट वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट कंटिन्यूटी। After that, I have discussed about what is continuous, okay, continuous function, and then I have given some solution related to continuity from Surendranath Day book, and I have discussed it from Sen Chattopadhyay mathematical book. Now, I have given you some solution, maximum number of solution of continuity and differentiability. So from continuity only, not differentiability, and some problems are still remains to solve from Surendranath Day book. Okay, so that problem definitely I have providing you in my another video from continuity only. Now I am going to start the differentiability, okay, from the continuity and differentiability chapter. Differentiability, now what is differentiability? If fx be a real number and fx be a real function and a be a real number, then we can divide the derivatives into two form. Derivative you have know from class 11, okay. So we should define the derivative into two part. The first is right hand derivative and the second is left hand derivative. The right hand derivative, that is written as like that: if f tends to h tends to 0, f of a plus h minus f of a by h, if it exists, it is called, if it exists, then it is called the right hand derivative, okay, of fx, right hand derivative of fx at x equal to a, and it denoted by r of f dash a. Next come to left hand derivative, limit h tends to 0, f of a minus h minus f a by minus h, if it is exist, then it is called the left hand derivative of fx and written as x equal to a, and it is denoted by L of f dash a. Now come to the differentiability definition. A function fx is said to be differentiable at a point x equal to a if its right hand derivative at x equal to a and left hand derivative are equal, okay. So that's I have to take. So hope you understand, this is my left hand derivative and this is my right hand derivative. If right hand derivative and left hand derivative are not equal, then we can say that fx is not differentiable at x equal to a, okay. Now we have to remark here, in each case h has taken as a positive and very small. So that's it, that's the introduction from differentiability. Hope you are understanding. Next come to some example so that we can understand the definition and we can understand the process that how it is a function is differentiable or not differentiable, okay. So first we see some example, after that we will solve the question of Surendranath Day book from SN Day book of Chaya Prakashani, okay. So let's come to first example. The example is given here: fx equal to x square is differentiable at x equal to 1. We have to show that it is differentiable at x equal to 1, and we have to find the f dash 1. So the right hand derivative, limit h tends to 0, f of 1 plus h minus f1 by h, that's equal to, by calculating we are getting the result is 2. Again the left hand derivative, actually the right hand derivative means here we have to take limit h tends to 0 plus 0 minus, okay, h tends to 0 plus and 0 minus, limit h tends to 0 minus. Now limit f dash 1 is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of 1 minus h minus f of 1 minus h, that's equals to limit h tends to 0 1 minus h whole square minus 1 square by minus h. Now if we calculating that, we are getting the result 2. So here my left hand derivative is equal to right hand derivative, that means the functions are differentiable, functions fx square is differentiable at x equal to 2. Now these are the calculations, f of x plus h, now function is given my x square, so we are putting here 1 plus h whole square, and f of 1 means 1 square, and here h is remaining. Next we breaking up this as a formula, we are getting this limit, putting these limits, we are getting 2. Similarly for left hand limit, here limit h tends to, we have to consider h tends to 0 minus, this is h tends to 0 plus and h tends to 0 minus. Actually 0 plus means from h tends to 0 from the positive value, okay, so that means from positive value it should comes to 0, that's why it is called 0 plus, okay. Next if h is moving from negative value to 0, okay, that is the smallest value to 0, so that's why it is called 0 minus, so that's why it is called left hand limit, left hand derivative, this is 0 plus and this is 0 minus, so that's why it is called left hand derivative and right hand derivative. So if we put over here, the value is 2, getting 2, so my left hand derivative is equal to right hand derivative, so that's why you can say that it is differentiable at x equal to 1, and my value of f dash 1 is equal to 2. Next come to another example, okay, here the examples is given, that so that if fx is equal to box x is not differentiable at x equals to 1, box x mean the greatest integer not exceeds x, that is the definition of box x. Now here 1 plus h, box of 1 plus h means 1, okay, so and box of 1 is also means 1, so here the left right hand derivative is equal to this, we are getting box of 1 plus h, this is box of, f of 1 plus h means box of 1 plus h, and my box of 1 plus h is 1, that is h is however small, if we are taking 1 plus h then box of this is equal to 1. So next move to my left hand derivative, so here it is my left hand derivative, so left hand derivative is limit h tends to 0 minus, 0 minus in this book minus is not given, so 0 minus f of 1 minus h minus f of 1 by minus h, so if we calculate that limit h tends to 0 minus box 1 minus h, now the value of box 1 minus h, that means equals to 0, because some value is take away from 1, that is if we calculate that, the value should be less than 1. Now the integer immediate less than 1 is 0, so that's why it is called 0, and the box of 1 is 1, so here we are getting the value as infinity, because my h tends to 0, okay, so 1 by 0 means infinity, so we are getting that the left hand derivative is not equal to right hand derivative, that means fx box x is not differentiable at x equals to a, understanding that. Next come to another example, the example is given here like that, so that if x is equal to 4/3 x to the power 4/3, f x equal to x to the power 4/3 is differentiable at x equals to 0, and hence find if f dash 0 and g x is equal to x to the power 3/2 is not differentiable at x equal to 0. So for that we are proceeding the similar way, and we are getting the result as 0. The left hand derivative is 0. Similarly, the right hand derivative, if we are taking here from right hand derivative is also getting 0. So my left hand derivative is equal to right hand derivative. That means it is differentiable at x equal to 0. Next come to the second function, x equal to 3 by 2. Here the right hand derivative and left hand derivative, we have to find that. Now this is my right hand derivative. Right hand derivative is 0, and my left hand derivative from here we can find easily. The left hand derivative limit, it is coming like that. A limit h is to 0 minus h to the power 1 by 2, which is imaginary, which is not getting any, we are not getting any value of this. So the left hand derivative of this function is not exist, so it is not differentiable at x equal to 0. This guys, these solutions are very helpful to you. This will come, this is very helpful for your class 12th exam. Okay, class 12th exam and up to graduation level. So next come to another, move to another question. Question is given here, so that the function fx 1 plus x, it is defined as x not equal to 2, and 5 minus x if x greater than 2 is not differentiable at x equal to 2. So if we are taking the left hand derivative and right hand derivative, the left hand derivative is this. This is my left hand derivative. Limit h tends to 0, 5 minus this. So if we are getting the answer minus 1. Similarly, if we are taking the right hand derivative, limit f dash 2, that's equal to, we are taking f of 2 minus h minus 2, limit h tends to 0, 1 plus 2 minus h minus 3, minus h in denominator. So we are getting the result, limit h tends to 0 minus h by minus h, that's equal to 1. So limit h tends to 0, 1 means 1. So my left hand derivative is not equal to right hand derivative, so that's equal to, so fx is not differentiable at x equals to 2. Similarly, come to another, quickly move to another question. Very important question these are. Fx is equal to 1 plus sin x, when 0 less or equal to x less than pi by 2, and 1 when x less than 0. We have to show that f dash 0 does not exist. So for that we have right hand derivative. We are taking right hand derivative. Now for right hand derivative, limit h tends to 0 plus minus f of h, and h tends to 0 plus means the value should be lying between 0 and pi by 2. So we are taking the function as 1 plus sin x, sin h here, and we are getting like this. Similarly, for x tends to 0 minus f of 0 minus h, so that means f of minus h, 0 minus h means minus h. Now for h tends to 0 minus, okay, h tends to 0 minus, we are getting the functional value as 1, so 1 minus 1. Now here again this is 0, this is 1, so the left hand limit and right hand limit are not equal. So f dash 0 does not exist, we can say that. Let us quickly move to another question. Let fx is equal to mx plus c, and f of 0 is equal to f dash 0 is equal to 1. We have to find f of 2. Clearly f of 0 is equal to 0 means f of 0 is equal to 1 means c equal to 1 by from the function we are getting that. Now f dash 0 is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of 0 plus h minus f of 0 by h. That means limit h tends to 0 f of h minus f of 0 by h. After calculating that, we are getting the result like that. That means limit h tends to 0 m equal to m. So f dash 0 is equal to 1, so means m is equal to 1. So c is equal to 1 and m is equal to 1. Now my fx is what? X plus 1 we are getting. Now if we have to find the value of f of 2, putting this value in the place of this, we are getting 3 as a result. Next come move to one very good theorem, that is the relation between the continuity and differentiability. Every differentiable function is continuous, but every continuous function need not be differentiable. We have to remember this. Every differentiable function is continuous, but every continuous function need not be differentiable. Now this is the student, this is the statements for the proof. The proof is given in CBSC RS Agarwal math book. You can see it from the proof. I am not discussing the proof. I suggest you that viewers, I suggest you that you should go through the proof for understanding. Next come to the example that of this relation, that every differentiable function is continuous, but every continuous function is not differentiable. So here one example is given, so that the function is defined as fx is equal to x sin 1 by x when x not equal to 0 and 0 when x equal to 0 is continuous but not differentiable at x equal to 0. So we have already discussed the above function for continuity at x equal to 0. For at x equals to 0, the above function is continuous or not, that is discussed already. Okay, you can see this from my solutions of continuity that I have given from Surendranath Dev book. I think this function is continuous or not at x equal to 0, that I have given in that solution. So you should check out from there. It is continuous. Okay, now let us take the differentiability of it, that is, it is differentiable at x equal to 0 or not. For that we are taking the left hand derivative, right hand derivative first, limit x tends to h tends to 0, f of 0 plus h minus f of 0 by h. Sorry viewers. So that's equals to limit h tends to 0, f of 0 plus h minus f of 0 by h. And that's equals to limit h tends to 0, h sin 1 by h. Now, h cancelize here. H and h should be cancelized here. So we are getting limit h to 0 sin 1 by h, which does not, this sign, this limit is does not exist. Hence fx is not differentiable. We can say fx is not differentiable at x equal to 0. So we can say that the function fx is equal to x sin 1 by x when x is not equal to 0 and 0 when x equal to 0 is continuous at x equal to 0, but it is not differentiable at x equal to 0. So this is one proof. Similarly, come to another example which is continuous but not differentiable. So let us come another example. The example is given here, that so that the function is given here, so that fx is equal to modulus of x minus 2 is continuous but not differentiable at x equal to 2. So if here my f2 is equal to 2 minus 2, that is 0. So limit x tends to 2 plus fx is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of 2 plus h, that is equal to limit h tends to 0 2 plus h minus 2. So limit h tends to 0 modulus of h, that gets the result is equal to 0. Next come to limit x tends to 0 minus fx, that is limit h tends to 0 f of 2 minus h, that is limit h tends to 0 2 minus h minus 2, and that's equal to limit h tends to 0 minus h, that's equal to 0. So my left hand limit and right hand limit together with the functional value at x equal to 2 is equal to 0. So fx is continuous at x equal to 2. Okay, next come to its differentiability test. So next come to its right hand derivative. So the right hand derivative is like that, f of 2 plus h minus f of 2 by h, limit h tends to 0. So this is the modulus function. So 2 plus h minus 2 is minus 0, that's divided by h. So we are getting limit mod h by h. So that's getting the value of h by h, that is equal to 1. Next come to left hand derivative. Left hand derivative, this is 2 minus h. So again we are getting 2 minus h means 2 minus h minus 2. So the value is limit h tends to 0 minus h by h, that is h by minus h, that is minus 1.